For today's hero guide, we have Scorpius. Scorpius is an easy to play hero and a marksman who can change the tide of the team fights because of its passive, which allows him an edge over other marksmen even in the early game. His passive is that when Scorpius gets a hero kill or assist, he gains 15% movement speed, 40% attack speed for 4 seconds, and it will keep on increasing. That's why I think even if you buy less attack speed item on him, he is still so OP. His skill 1 is that he shoots a piercing arrow at a target direction, which pushes yourself backward, deal physical damage to enemies it hit, and also apply 30% movement speed slowdown for 3 seconds. You can also use this skill as a blink to move through the walls, but remember, you can only move through walls which are not that thick. But it won't work if the walls are thick, even if you are closer to the walls. If any enemy jumps on you, you can also use this skill to keep a distance from them. Because it's in piercing attack, so it is going to pass through the enemy and deal damage to backline, that's why it's an AoE skill. His skill 2 is that he set up a trap at the target location for 30 seconds, which provide him vision. When the trap is triggered by an enemy, it deal physical damage to the nearby enemies and apply 50% movement slowdown for 1.5 seconds. The bad thing about these traps is that it can also be seen by the enemies, so they will try to avoid it. So don't put the traps in the front road or somewhere. Try to put them in the bush so that enemies don't see them. Even with the max cooldown or like no cooldown reduction, you can summon up to 3 traps at the max. This skill is also not that good because it provides very less damage. Even if the enemy triggers it, you won't be able to see the enemy for much longer, and you cannot see your traps on the minimap. So if you have to know that your traps has been triggered or not, then you have to swap the screen to check if the trap has been triggered by the enemy or not. If the enemies are right in front of you, you can directly use your trap to slow them down. And there is one tip for you to use the trap. You can use the trap near the enemy buff camp. So when you check your trap after swapping the screen, you will know that if the trap is triggered, that means the buff has been taken. But there is one more thing. Try to use this kind of trap as 10 seconds interval so that you will know the timing at what time your buffs will be gone, like after 30 seconds if they are not triggered. What I do is I use these traps at a minute or a 30 second mark so that I'll know that after 30 seconds my trap will be gone. Your ultimate is that when you use it for the next 9 seconds, your range and damage both are going to increase. And your basic attack will pierce through enemies, that's why he is so deadly in the team fight. And if the enemy is standing in front of the tower, you can still hit the tower. So I recommend you to use your ultimate when your team is going for a tower dive or when your team is going to push the tower, so that if any enemy is standing there, you can still be able to hit the tower also. Your range is so much enhanced that you can attack the tower even if there are no minions. But you have to stay on the edge so that you don't get attacked by the tower as well. You have to find that area. And this is applicable to all towers. For using spell on Scorpius, you can use Flash so that it can allow him to go through the thicker walls. Roar is also very good, which is going to boost your damage a lot. Try to use it after using your ultimate. You can also use Disrupt, which will allow you to play aggressive with your ultimate. And overall, Disrupt is really good in the team fights when your team is going to tower dive. Purify is another good option for immunity to crowd control. Like when your opponent have a lot of CC or your team is not having any damage, then Purify is the best option because you don't want to get CC while using your ultimate. So now for the Scorpius build item, this is the build that I use on him. First item is Fleshy Boots. Normally these are for cooldown reduction. If you check out his cooldown on his ultimate, it is a lot as compared to other heroes. His ultimate cooldown is a lot even at the max level. That's why you need cooldown reduction to reduce the cooldown of his ultimate as well as his other skills. So now my next item is Lightning Dagger. It gives me movement speed, attack speed and critical jump. After that, my next item is Spell Shards to give me physical attack speed and 10% lives. And most importantly, it's passive of dealing 8% of the enemy's current HP damage. After that, my next item is for the armor penetration, that is Shield Breaker, for giving me 32 physical attack, 10% cooldown reduction, and 40% of my damage will be the armor penetration. And then my next item is again a lifesteal item, Blood Drinker, which gives me physical attack and lifesteal. After that, I buy the Triumph Wing to increase my damage more, as whenever enemy are on 50% less HP, my damage is going to increase by 30% on them. Now for my last item, I normally decide from these three items. So if I don't want to buy any penetration item, then I go for Brilliant Blade because it gives me a lot of physical attack and critical damage. Then for penetration, if my team is on losing side and I want that penetration item as soon as possible, so I buy Umbra X because it costs me less gold as compared to the Gale Quill, though Gale Quill is a lot better because it gives you attack speed as well as the critical chance and physical attack. So I normally buy Gale Quill if my team is on the winning side, so I pre-order it as my last item. And if you want to buy any anti-lifesteal item, then directly go for Doombringer, which gives you physical attack, 10% lifesteal, and its unique passive of reducing the HP regen of the enemy. Now if you see this full build, I am having 25% cooldown reduction, 15 from fleshy boots and 10 from spell shards. So to get to the max cooldown reduction, that is 40%, just take the blue buff from the enemy and you are good to go. But if you buy your last item as Umbra Axe, then you directly get 40% cooldown reduction by completing your full build. So there is one more thing to notice in this build, that is the Blood Drinker and Spell Shards. Both of these are the lifesteal item in the build. And if you buy the anti-lifesteal item, that is Doombringer, which gives you again more 10% lifesteal. So if I combine all of these, you are getting 45% lifesteal. You are already having attack damage and attack speed from your skill set, which will allow you to play more aggressive. So no matter how much damage you are taking, you will regen HP with the lifesteal. And if you are having your spell as Purified, then I don't think anyone can stop you even with your CC if you have the right timing when to use the Purify. So in the late game, if you have decided to sell your boots and have not bought the Umbra Axe, then make sure to buy it because you will again get that penetration, physical attack, and most importantly that 15% cooldown reduction back. But in the late game, as you know, enemies also have a lot of damage, so to have a little sustain, buy a defense item, that is Blood Fury, which is the best item on Scorpius in defense category. For best partners with the Scorpius, you can use Drash so that you can deal more poke damage on the enemies. Try to aim your skill one better on the enemies. And even if any enemy triggers your trap somewhere in the map, your Drash is going to go and attack them. Next is Inali, which is I think overall very good for any marksman heroes who depend on the attack speed. She will help you to deal more damage on them. So next partner is Kura. I think he is the best one, which will help you to play aggressive. So when you use your ultimate, you want to play aggressive, you want to utilize that bonus damage and attack range. So Kura will give you shield and damage reduction for 5 seconds. So that's all for this video. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to this channel. Check out my other hero guides. Link is available in the description. Let me know in the comments below which hero guide you want me to make next. Join my Discord server to vote for my upcoming videos. Link is available in the description and on my channel about page.